and administration of Eastern View High School, we welcome you to our 13th commencement exercise. Today, we are assembled to recognize, celebrate, and witness academic achievement, the awarding of a high school diploma. At this time, would you please rise as the class of 2021 begins their processional.
Thank you. Thank you. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the class of 2021's commencement ceremony. My name is Elliot Davis.
And my name is Valeria Moreno Ruiz. We had the honor of serving as officers for the class of 2021.
Will you please remain standing while our Marine Corps JROTC Color Guard presents the colors and honors our nation in the playing of our national anthem. Our band director is directed by Mr. Adam Roach. Please remain standing until our Marine Corps JROTCs has retired the colors. You may be seated.
Tonight, as we begin our ceremony, with respect of the class of 2021, please turn off all cell phones and electronic devices. Thank you. The class of 2021 would like to recognize the following guests in attendance to stand and be recognized. Members of the Culpeper County School Board, members of the Culpeper County Board of Supervisors, members of the Culpeper Town Council, thank you for being part of this special day. You may be seated.
It is my honor to introduce Dr. Anthony Brads, Superintendent of Culpeper County Public Schools.
Dr. Addo, I'm going to go off script just a little bit. Is it great to be outside here together tonight? Absolutely. On behalf of the school board and the central administration for Culpeper County Public Schools, I would like to congratulate the Eastern View High School graduating class of 2021. Especially this year, I want to thank you, your parents, your family, your friends, and certainly your teachers for the collective effort in getting you to this milestone of high school graduation. For all school division employees, graduation is the fulfillment of why we do what we do. This senior class is comprised of 274 graduates who, in my opinion, are well prepared for their next steps in terms of their plans for employment, enlistment, and enrollment. By that I mean by the numbers. 81 of your classmates are heading off to the workplace. 18 of your classmates are joining the military in service to our country. 84 of your classmates are planning to attend two-year colleges, trade schools, or technical schools, and 89 of your classmates are planning to attend a four-year college or university. In addition, this senior class is leaving high school with 220 graduates having attained a career in technical education diploma seal, and with many of those having also earned an even higher standard of an industry certification or state licensure. Also, 81 of you are graduating with 2,170 college credits, inclusive of 20 graduates earning an associate's degree. That deserves a round of applause right there. Your extraordinary accomplishments in a very unusual senior year have been a collaborative effort. Your parents, teachers, coaches, administrators, school staff, and school board members have helped you navigate this school year. To be clear, you have worked very hard over many years to get to this point. This unprecedented situation faced by the class of 2021 in no way diminishes your educational career. It is simply an exclamation point to your accomplishment of achieving the status of high school graduate. You've shown determination and perseverance in finishing what you started. In the months and years ahead, you'll look back and realize that you can do anything you set your mind to. As this pandemic hopefully nears an end, please be diligent and safe, yet also aware of the needs of others. Continue to care about others, stay connected with those who are feeling isolation, and stay in communication with one another in some form or another. I wish each of you much success in your future endeavors. Congratulations. We are proud of each and every one of you. Thank you.
We now present to you the EVHS choirs. Our choirs are directed by Mrs. Tiffany Richtarski. They will be singing For Good from Wicked the Musical, arranged by Shaw.
Made of what I learned from you, you'll be with me. like a handprint on my heart. And now whatever way our stories end, I know you have rewritten mine by being my friend. Like a ship blown from its mooring by a wind off the sea, like a sea drawn by a sky bird in a distant port, who can say just to clear the air, I ask forgiveness for the things I've done you blame me for. Oh, da 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 da. And none of it seems to matter anymore. Like a comet over orbit as it passes the sun, like a stream that leaves a boulder halfway through the wood, who can say if I've been changed for the better? I do believe I have been changed for the better. And because I
before I begin tonight, I would like to start with thanking the staff and faculty of Eastern View High School for everything you have done for us this year in leading us through our senior year and making it the most possible. I would also like to thank the parents of every single one of us. Without you, we would not be standing here today. Good evening, class of 2021, faculty, family, and friends. My name is Abby Schrader, and I am your honor graduate speaker for the evening. I am so honored to have the opportunity to speak to you tonight. I was completely surprised and a little worried when I got the call asking me to speak with only 3 days until graduation and mere hours to come up with a title. With my heart racing and head twirling, I desperately searched for a speech title I liked. My mom jokingly suggested turning in To Be Determined so that I would not have to choose a title at all. However, the more I thought on that idea, the more I realized just how this phrase represents not only me, but all of us during our entire senior year. The phrase to be determined is commonly used as a placeholder when a decision has yet to be made. It is meant to be a very temporary solution, fleeing with the wind and soon replaced by a more permanent answer. Personally, I feel as though my life is made up of TBDs because of how badly I hate making any decisions. What shoes to wear with an outfit, how to do my hair for prom, what restaurant to go eat at. These small daily decisions are constant annoyances but can be easily managed. But when the decisions carry more weight and responsibility, like where do I want to go to college, and what to do with the rest of my life, the TBD becomes a crutch to be leaned on, causing one to stop moving forward and staying in the comfort of the familiar and safe. This crutch is one I know all too well. I used it frequently to avoid conversation after conversation about college and choosing university for the fall. It crippled my ability to make a decision until the week of the May 1st deadline. And as I was trying my very best to avoid the TBD, there were late night research sessions, dorky spreadsheets, evaluating various colleges, pros and cons lists, sorting through the thousands of emails from colleges I had never even heard of, like Ohio Wesleyan, intense conversations with everyone and anyone who would listen, flipping coins, and yes, lots of tears. However, after all of this, I still could not bring myself to decide. The TBD had allowed me to remain frozen, unwilling to drop the crutch and take that first step. It wasn't until my parents sat me down that last week, against my will, and simply said choose, that I was able to finally let go of the crutch and jump with both feet into the future I'd been avoiding. I think that many of us have felt this anxiety towards the future this year. Whether we are off to universities or trade schools, going into the workforce or joining the military, deciding what to do with the rest of our lives is something all of us have been struggling with. And the faraway future wasn't the only thing we had to confront this year either. It was the immediate to be determined that the pandemic created for us this year and that challenged us with overcoming our greatest adversity. Not knowing the fate of in-person learning, our sports seasons, the much anticipated musicals and concerts, and our one and only prom and graduation. Our entire senior year, the year we have waited for our whole academic lives, was up in the air. But we made it through. We stand here today on graduation day, victorious through the online learning and being separated for so long. With the help of our faculty, staff, family members, and everyone else in the community, we have made the most of our senior year. We were able to have altered versions of concerts, sports, prom, pep rallies, and so much more. Some of these alterations even turned out to be blessings. Getting a break in the middle of the week all year from structured class time was a nice change that the pandemic gave us. I'm sure the teachers also appreciated not having to stare into a screen of black squares on Zoom or stand in a silent, half-empty classroom for a day. Also, I don't know about you, but I loved seeing Mr. Murphy and Mr. Settle pedal around campus on their bikes. And as an added bonus, the underclassmen were so scared of losing the spirit sick to us that they didn't even bother showing up to the senior-only pep rally this year. This year could have gone so differently, but we have been able to overcome the immense adversity thrown our way, and we have come out on the other side better for it. We are resilient, we are resourceful, and we are unstoppable. And hey, if we can complete high school online in the middle of a pandemic, there isn't any challenge waiting for us that we can't conquer. We must simply be unafraid of making the wrong choice and release the crutch, confident in our own ability to stand on our own two feet. So from now on, change the TBD in your life from to be determined to tearing the barriers down. Thank you.
Wow, here we are. We actually made it. We are crossing the finish line, making it to the buzzer, reaching the end. The end. Or is this just the beginning? Good evening, Cyclone families, staff, and of course my fellow graduates. My name is Jamil Abed, and I have the distinct privilege to have been chosen by the class of 2021 to speak today. I, just as all of you before me, would not be here today if it weren't for so many people. People that I would like to take a moment to acknowledge. To the administrators, teachers, and staff of Eastern View High School, we thank you. This year has been nothing like what we had dreamed of, but you had made every effort to make it more than we could have imagined. It does not go unnoticed, and we, the class of 2021, have seen it acknowledge it, and truly appreciate it. To every nutritional service staff, environmental staff, school nurse, and maintenance tech, you have gone above and beyond to keep us safe this year, and we are so immensely grateful. To my parents, the foundation you have provided for me is beyond measure. You have been my biggest cheerleaders, and most importantly, my biggest critics. You gave me confidence to chase my dreams while humbling me to understand my privilege. You have made me feel that nothing is impossible, but more importantly, that none of it matters if I'm not a good person. I couldn't be more grateful, so thank you to not only my parents, but to all the parents, families, and friends for being here today and supporting us through this crazy journey. Well, to say it has been an unbelievable year would be an understatement. There has been a pandemic that derailed not only our senior year, but the entire world. People finding joy in TikTok, murder hornets, I mean, for real? Everybody wondered what happened to the Tiger King. We have also seen unimaginable grief, a crazy election, and injustices that hopefully have opened the eyes of everyone around the world. When our kids read history books in the future, they are never going to believe it. But at least we will be able to scold them and say, well, back in my day. On the other hand, there were some positives. We got to spend more time with our families, work from home, and stay in our PJs. We ate anything and everything because, I mean, who was going to see us anyways? We had more lenient schedules, could work and go to school at the same time, and most importantly, we learned how to sleep during class without getting caught. Wait, you guys didn't hear that. It definitely was not your average year, but hey, as Woody Allen said, if you want to make God laugh, tell him your plans. That was definitely true this year. Our plans changed. The unexpected and unimaginable happened. And the truth is, it stung. But guess what? We are okay. In fact, we flourished. What didn't kill us most definitely make us stronger. The events of this year taught us to not stress about the small things and appreciate every opportunity. We learned that we are more adaptable than we thought and stronger when we come together. We no longer fear failure. We have come too far for that, but we should be terrified of regret. We learned that there are no picking sides in human decency. None of us are truly free until all of us are free. And we must speak that truth, even if our voice shakes. Look, sometimes the road of life takes unexpected turns, and you have no choice but to follow. But you may end up exactly where you're supposed to be. Class of 2021, we are exactly where we are supposed to be. We made it. Now is our time. I would like all of you to stand up. Look at those around you. Look at the faces you have shared these walls with, made memories with, and formed lifetime friendships with. Regardless of race, religion, class rank, popularity, or status, we all stand here together as one, as the class of 2021. I, for one, am proud of what we have accomplished. In the words of Snoop Dogg, I want to thank us for believing in us and doing all the hard work. I want to thank us for never quitting, for always trying to give more than we receive and doing more right than wrong. Lastly, I want you guys to repeat this one after me. I want to thank us for just being us.
I want to thank us for just being us.
You may be seated. So here we go. When you move that tassel over today, remember these words from James Bond. The world needs you, your will, your imagination, your appetite for adventure, and needs your hands, your minds, and your hearts. The world doesn't need a hero. We just need people with the courage to create. You have the most singular opportunity for greatness ever offered to any generation. Take it. Save the world. This is most certainly not the end. It is our beginning. Rise up, make it matter, and make a difference. Thank you.
Hi, guys. My name is Kelly Doherty, and I am the chosen speaker representing the Student Council. I am very happy to give this commencement speech to the well-deserving graduating class of 2021. Going into this year, our senior year, we reached our peak in high school. We were the seniors. This was the year that we've been waiting for ever since we started preschool. Looking back over the past 13 years, we've constantly faced all kinds of challenges, whether we realized it or not. In elementary school, most of our struggles dealt with adding, multiplying, and listening to our teachers when they told us it was nap time. Although these obstacles weren't as hard as most we face today, they are still things we struggled with and had to overcome by learning from them. Then came middle school, where the struggles we were faced with became more apparent and real to us, some of which included harder classes, more homework, individual changes within ourselves and the people around us, and if we were playing kickball or dodgeball in gym class. These challenges contributed to helping us learn from our mistakes and adapt more efficiently. Finally, we reached high school. We were at the bottom of the pyramid again as little freshmen, the underclassmen. The biggest problems we faced included things like getting lost, finding people to sit with at lunch, and in my case, I was both a freshman and the new girl from West Virginia. We constantly learned how to get past these bumps in the road as we made our way to the top of the food chain, the head honchos of Eastern View High School, the seniors, class of 2021. Everyone knows the main hardships we faced this year, the Google Meets, the 20 Canvas assignments we found every day, the new mask and social distancing requirements we didn't think we'd ever see in school, the separation between not only our class, but the entire school with virtual and blended learning. But also, we definitely struggled with staying awake during class, wishing we were still in preschool, regretting those times we had opportunities for nap time that we didn't take. We had the rough end of the stick this year in the most unexpected year for our last year of high school. This is one of the biggest challenges we faced in our lifetimes, but we made it here today, all of us graduating and moving on from this extremely complicated year that we had to adapt to in so many ways. All of these stumbling blocks we encountered throughout school, we've learned to conquer them and move forward to better ourselves and our future. This goes to show that we are strong enough to overcome any adversity or storm that comes our way. We can succeed through all the impossibilities of life, just as we have our whole lives. We're at our peak right now, but just as these aren't the only challenges we are going to face in life, this isn't our only peak. And lastly, I want to leave you with a very inspirational quote from the respectable Lil Wayne that states, "Real G's move in silence like lasagna." And no, I don't mean the Italian food we get from Peppers before game days. I mean moving forward in silence like the real G's that Eastern View High School has made us.
High school is like a bad first date. You see the profile picture and think, wow, I can't wait to meet this person. And by person, I mean high school. First dates are supposed to be exciting while also a tad bit stressful, like the very first day of high school. Whether it be high school or a first date, entering into this new realm is similar to being a sponge. Almost a fist, this first date is like freshman orientation. You go there ready to absorb any and every piece of information thrown at you, regardless of its importance. But when you finally get there, you're gradually turned off and want to get the heck up out of there. They chew with their mouth open, sneeze all over the bread, or even blow their nose in the most grotesque way. Oh my God. Even when I'm trying to eat. Except you find that one thing that makes you want to get to know them more. Like the offer to pay for your meal. At least that's what would make me stay a little bit longer. Yeah, I wouldn't know. I've never been on a proper first date. That may say a little bit about me, but hey, free food. Anyways, to formally introduce myself, my name is Jordan Peterson Chandler, and I am the longest standing member of the Senior Class Council. First, I would like to thank all of the families and friends who came out to support and celebrate your graduates. Also, thank you to all the teachers and administrators who helped us get to where we are now. No, seriously, this might be the most genuine thanks you'll ever receive because a lot of us would not be walking across this stage without you. Shout out to Mr. Miller for the extra 250 points to our overall grade. We earned it. All right, now it's time to be inspirational. It's been quite an eventful year. However, it forced us to pause and reevaluate our lives, even cherish them in every aspect, emotionally, academically, socially, and spiritually. From having our junior year, the most important and hardest year, cut short, to dealing with global and social issues that impacted everyone simultaneously, these trials really took a toll on a lot of us. I know hearing the news that school was canceled for the rest of the year last spring was something that most kids would be excited about. I mean, I was a little happy because that meant no more 20-page outlines for Mr. Jones's class, but overall, the events that occurred following the school closure, including an international pandemic, or as some would call her, Miss Rona, the death of George Floyd and the rise of the Black Lives Matter movement, and last, but never least, the hate crimes towards Asian American people and the LGBTQIA+ community. These events were staggering while also incredibly traumatizing to people of these communities. The events that occurred from the spring of 2020 to honestly this whole academic year was just a hot mess. In all, our last year of high school is like no other. And I and everyone else on this planet am truly proud of each and every one of you. To adults, this may sound like a bunch of complaining from an 18-year-old, but for our mental health and sanity, this school year was hard. Confidently speaking, the class of 2021 is the strongest class to ever walk across the stage. We overcame adversity and took it with a grain of salt. Or, as us Gen Z would say, it was some slight. Or, as my mom would say, tears in a bucket, forget it, and keep it moving. So, I guess you could say this bad first date wasn't all that bad. The resiliency that we've acquired this year is a far greater lesson than any we could have learned in the classroom. As Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. said, the ultimate measure of a man is not where he stands in moments of comfort and convenience, but where he stands at times of challenge and controversy. We are here, and we are here together in one piece. I guess paying for that meal was a good enough reason to finish strong. Lastly, I know a lot of y'all are ready to get your diploma and get out of here, but just wait. Regardless of where you're headed, whether you're going to college, serving in the military, or just going home to take a nap, congratulations to the class of 2021. We did the dang thing.
Let me guess, how can I compete with Jay-Z, Lil Wayne, and Snoop Dogg? Did I just hear all three of those? Okay. Welcome again to our graduation. At this time, I would like to share some data with you and recognize a few folks. The class of 2021 received a total of $52,158 in scholarships from local organizations and a total of $552,955 in scholarships from colleges, universities, and other organizations. Ladies and gentlemen, that brings our grand total this year for that class of 2021 of scholarship dollars to $605,113. Great job, guys. Excellent. Now let's recognize a few of our graduates. Would the following graduates please stand and remain standing? Cameron Bacham, Christopher Beachboard, Edwin Rodriguez, Paige Hansen, Brandon Kearns, Tyler Kearns, Jack Perry, Pedro Roman Rivera, Jacob Rulapal, Kevin Lloyd, Evan Scott, James Sutter, Jackson Toole, Brianna Tyson, Natalie Urahe, Elijah Waters, Evan Woodworth, Gavin Young, and Paige Folsom. Ladies and gentlemen, these 18 graduates. These 18 graduates will be going into the military, and you'll see some of them wearing the red, white, and blue cord, which signifies that they have enlisted for a commitment to our country. But please remain standing. Will all those in our audience who are currently serving in the military or those who are retired from the military, if you are able, please stand to be recognized for your selfless service to our country. Thank you guys, and you may be seated. For the class of 2021, we have 6 sets of twins graduating this year. When I call your name, may you please stand. Brittany and Brian Avignetta. Alicia and Sam Bynum. Ethan and Robert Fairfax. Destiny Ramon McKinnon. Alexi and Christina Plata. And Cecilia and John Rose. All I can say is, wow, you and your twin have been together for 13 years of schooling. You made it. Congratulations, and thank you, and you may be seated. Now, may the following graduates please stand. Andrea Stratif, Jairo Benitez, Ernesto Barbosa Alvarado, Emily Castro Martinez, Jonathan Chavez, Mauricio Favela, Luz Dominguez, Alex Figueroa Vasquez, David Franco, Macarena Alonso, Haley Henry, Logan Hogshead, Alexi Lopez, Savannah Jackson, Vance Cosis, Aaliyah Marshall, Damian Martinez, Wendy Martinez Rosinos, Jesse McMillian, Blake McPeak, Jasmine Strother, Brooklyn Taylor, Leo Torres Alonso, Brooklyn Taylor, Leo Torres Alonso, Derek Hernandez, Brianna Melendez, Ryan Rosales, Chantel Moore, Valeria Ruiz, Rebecca Navalani, Laura Nexley, Kanalia Newman, Jessica Perez Gomez, Jack Perry, Alexi Platter, Christina Platter, Ariana Quiones, Angelie Reyes, Pella Reyes, Tyree Robinson, Michelle Chavez, Johan Mendez, Candace Shackelford, Eric Seguenza, Brianna Rice, Natalia Urahe, Selena Ventura, Vanessa Walkup, Cameron Williams, and Shaylen Williams. Ladies and gentlemen, you have 49 graduates in front of you that are wearing green tassels to signify the first in their family to graduate high school. We are very proud of them for this great milestone and accomplishment. Congratulations, guys. You may be seated. Will the following graduates please stand? Jamil Abed, Crystal Brown, Rachel Cook, Haley Goldlightly, Sanaya Joyce, Gavin Campbell, Carissa Campbell, Macklin Luckett-Bill, Brantley Meadows, Jason Molina, Chantel Moore, Annalie Page, Paige Rankins, Courtney Renan, Michelle Rojo Chavez, Abigail Schrader, Rebecca Smith, Elizabeth Street, Autumn Taylor, and Avery Ward. Ladies and gentlemen, these graduates have earned an associate's degree, which translates into possibly the first 2 years of a bachelor's degree while they were in high school. And all of them graduated college of 2 years of bachelor's degree before they did high school. Amazing. Congratulations, guys. Good job. Please be seated. Will the following graduates please stand? Brittany Avignetta, Elena Barrett, Imani Bond, Stephanie Miranda, Lloyd Davis, Adam Dotson, Haley Dotson, Macarena Garcia Alonso, Ashton King, Madison Moore, Valeria Moreno Ruiz, Jordan Peterson Chandler, Courtney Renan, Michelle Chavez, Abigail Shadley, Emily Sufkin, Taylor Walker, and Sarah Woods. These graduates are early college scholars. They have earned at least 15 hours of transferable college credit while completing the requirements for an advanced studies diploma in high school. Congratulations, guys. Good job. Please be seated. Will the following students please stand? Brantley Meadows, Abigail Schrader, Rebecca Smith. And please remain standing. Ladies and gentlemen, these three are in the top 1% of the class of 2021. Please stand Crystal Brown, Paige Rankins, and Elizabeth Street. These three that just stood up, ladies and gentlemen, now you see the top 2% of the class of 2021. Please remain standing. The following students, please join them. Rachel Cook, Sanaya Joyce, Savannah McQueenie, Avery Ward, Jason Molina, Dana Morgan, Chantel Moore, Elizabeth Upton, and Faith Wood. Ladies and gentlemen, the class of 2021, EVHS, top 5% of their class. They have distinguished themselves by many years of hard work and academic excellence. We congratulate you and we hope for the best. Thank you guys, please be seated. Will the following students please stand? Macklin Luckinbill, Marie Claire Metricardi, Brantley Meadows, Chantel Moore, Macy Moore, Madison Moore, Valeria Ruiz, Jordan Peterson Chandler, Isabella Patrice, Gabrielle Porter Wilson, Paige Rankins, Faith Seishin, Abigail Schrader, Rebecca Smith, Emily Sumpfin, Elizabeth Upton, Taylor Walker, Avery Ward, Lewis West, Sarah Woods, and Julia Wortman. These graduates are members of the National Honor Society. They have also distinguished themselves through academic and community service excellence in their field while they were in high school. Ladies and gentlemen, congratulations. Please be seated. I know you want me to rush on, but a little rain will not hurt. We will be fine. Will all Eastern View High School staff faculty please stand? Graduates, parents, family members, these are the bone, the rock behind all these students. Students, stand up and give them a hand of applause. Thank you so very much. Will all those visitors who have graduated from Eastern View High School please stand? Do we have any visitors returning to us? I see a few. Fantastic. Please put your hands together, give me a hand, welcome back, and thank you for coming. Now to the part where I get to give the class of 2021 my message. Hello and welcome to your last day at Eastern View High School. As a senior, you are at the beginning. Well, you are the jumping off point of a new chapter in your lives, and I am honored to celebrate your exciting accomplishment and watch you take flight. You, the class of 2021, are one resilient and special group. None of us could have predicted the challenges the class of 2021 would have faced this year. Your senior year started with deciding whether to attend school 2 days a week and 3 days virtual or 100% virtual. We then added to this challenge a new learning management system called Canvas that you had to master immediately. We then had you sign and agree to the following school's health and safety guidelines. You know them all. Wear a mask appropriately over your nose and mouth. Maintain a 6 feet of social distance and wash your hands for 20 seconds. And on top of these, you had to navigate the traditional senior challenges of passing courses, preparing for graduation, managing your social and emotional interactions, all while planning for a life after high school. It wasn't a big deal at all. Some of the adjustments to your senior year included a typical class of 20 to 25 students in a normal school year now became 2 students, 5 or 10. A cafeteria table full of students laughing, smiling, and playfully interacting with each other became a table of 2 people sitting 6 feet apart, and they had to scream across the table so they could hear each other. This new and completely unfamiliar experience was added to the challenges you were handed. We all had to make the decision of how to move forward with the hand that had been dealt to us. Now, an author, Joshua Marine, said, challenges are what makes life interesting. I better hurry up. Overcoming them is what makes life meaningful. Students, parents, teachers, administrators, and local organizations rolled up their sleeves and got to work to make this year the best that we could make it, especially for our seniors. Many of you found hope by shifting your focus away from what you lost to how you can adapt. High school sports teams were back playing again. You came out and then played your hearts out during the short seasons. Now, remember the senior drive-through breakfast? The best biscuits and juice we've ever had, right, Elijah Hoskins? I heard you enjoyed it a lot. How about the modified pep rally and homecoming king and queen, Gio Maxi and Gabrielle Porter Wilson? Loved it. Don't forget our 2 proms and crowning 2 kings and 2 queens, Logan Ashwell and Carly Mills, and Elliot Davis and Rebecca Green. Shout out to you guys. You remember our first senior drive-in movie night? What a fun time we had. AJ West in his pickup truck and a couch. Chilling behind the pickup truck watching Fast and Furious. That was exciting. All of us, students, teachers, parents, and community, shifted our perspective to gratefulness. Gratefulness that we're surviving or even thriving during a world health crisis. Grateful that we still had options and the ability to participate in school activities. Grateful that those around us came together and offered support. Grateful that our teachers offered endless grace with assignments and due dates. Grateful that although isolated, we had our families. We all gained a new perspective about our situation. Seniors, uncertain times are scary and hard, but asking yourself, how can I use this time to positively enrich the experiences of my senior year, switched our focus. The pandemic forced all of us to figure out what is important and what is not. Class of 2021, you have set yourself apart from previous graduates. With each executive order and change, each new curveball thrown at you, and you show determination and commitment to secure the future of your dreams. Your new perspective allows you to take advantage of them, benefit from the situation. You are indeed a resilient and special group. EVHS class of 2021, before I take my seat, I want you to always remember this. Things will happen in your life that you will have no control over. How you respond to it will determine your outcome. So as you move on to the next chapter in your life, whatever you decide to do, do it with confidence, Do it at 100% and do it with passion, attitude, swag, and your new perspective. Congratulations, class of 2021. And now, the presentation of the diplomas. Will the Eastern View High School graduating class of 2021 please stand?
Jameel S. Abed. Trey Michael Adona. Elijah Akbar. Alyssa Abigail Alvarado Alas. Herman S. Antezana. Garrett Daniel Appelt. Jairo Abraham Argueta Benitez. Logan Edward Ashwell. Brittany Avellaneda. Brian Avellaneda. Caleb Samuel Baker. Luca Duccino Banks. Ernesto Barbosa Alvarado. Alana Moore Barrett. Cameron Alexander Buckham. Christopher James Beachboard. Summer Jane Beaumont. Sarah Elizabeth Berry. John Philip Blackwell. Imani Ashanti Bond. Emma Lynn Bonilla. Gregory Shane Bradley. Cheyenne Alyssa Hope Brown. Krista Rose Brown, Associate's degree. Riley Elizabeth Brown. Edwin Giovanni Buenrostro Rodriguez. Jutamit Butsidwong. Alatea Isabella Bynum. Sam Bynum. Dante Carpenter. Gabriela Michelle Carrillo. Talia Alexis Castanera Soto. Emily Eileen Castro Martinez. Jonathan Alexander Chavez. Karina Nicole Chismar. Colin Nathaniel Christian. Gabriel Miles Clark. Kristen Natalie Clay. Lauren Janae Clyette. Mackenzie Emma Lucy Collins. Elijah Marcellus Cohn. Stephanie Gabriella Constanza Miranda. Rachel Nicole Cook, Associate's degree. Alfred James Cooper V. Sandra Mercedes Cuellar Ramirez. Lloyd Elliott Davis. Zachary Dean. Brianna Marie Diatley. James Douglas Deskins. Ryan Garrett Dickerson. Kendall Francis Disher. Adam Edward Dodson. Haley Nicole Dodson. Kelly Shannon Doherty. Lindsay Nicole Dolan. Luz Elena Dominguez. Aiden Connor Durica. Ethan Alexander Edwards. Timothy Lynn Edwards. Gabriela Michelle Escobar Valdez. Ethan Nathaniel Fairfax. Robert Samuel Fairfax. Mauricio Favela. Alex Vladimir Figueroa Vasquez. Gabriel Evan Fincham. Hannah Grace Fincham. Jonathan Fincham. Riley Elizabeth Fleming. Paige Mackenzie Folsom. David Eduardo Franco Miranda. Vivian Gabriela Galarza. Macarena Garcia Alonso. Kenny Duane George. Haley Marie Golightly, Associate's Degree. Angie Minette Gonzalez. Joyce Gonzalez Tapia. Colin Joel Gothard. Kalayla Cheyenne Gordeen. Richard Allen Graves. Mason Sebastian Gray. Rebecca Elizabeth Lake Green. Therese Monet Green. Jessidas Michael Griffiths. Carrie Paul Grigsby Jr. Caitlin Paige Hossey. Kelly Brian Hackley Jr. Brian Jacob Hall. William Gillette Harris. Ali Haug. Haley Nicole Henry. Armand Martez Henson. Brody Allen Hill. Logan Tyler Hogshead. Tatiana Brittany Holmes. Elijah Jacob Hoskin. Nathan Tyler Howell. Diaz Dakari Hunter. Justin Nasir Illyri. Alexi Iraeta Lopez. Kevin Mitchell Jackson Jr. Terry Omar Jackson Jr. Emily Jenkins. Justin Samuel Jenkins. Aiden Michael Job. Sanai Elizabeth Joyce, Associate's degree. Jose Juarez. Brandon Jacob Kearns. Chaz Michael Keen. Rebecca Elizabeth Kearns. Tyler Marshall Kearns. Gavin Colin Kimball, Associate's degree. Carissa Ann Kimball, Associate's degree. Ashton Mason King. Vance Britton Kosius. Abigail Paige Kress. Lauren Marie Cuby. Dylan Thomas Lacey. Taylor Faith Landon. Joshua Bryson Logan. Kevin Enrique Lord. Caden Jonathan Loy. Jesse Loya. Macklin Gerald Luckenbill, Associate's degree. Isabella Jaylin Lucier. Savannah Marie McQueenie. Nicole Brenda Moreno. Samuel Antonio Maria. Jonasia Arion Marr. Aliyah Imani Marshall. Damian Emilio Martinez. Wendy Esmeralda Martinez Recinos. Marie Claire Matricardi. Brian Giovanni Maxi. Bailey Luciana Mayer. Aiden Luke McCartan. Sarah Ann McKenzie. Jesse Allen McMillian. Blake Scott McPeak. Brinley Lauren Meadows, Associate's degree. Brianna Lynn Melfelt. Brianna Suzanne Melendez. Melanie Ann Mickle. Carly Ann Mills. Jason Alonso Molina, Associate's degree. Ryan Monroy Rosales. Chantel Robin Moore, Associate's degree. Macy Victoria Moore. Madison Taylor Moore. Valeria Moreno Ruiz. Dana Catherine Morgan. Thomas Aaron Morgan. Cameron J. Muncie. Edgardo Antonio Munguia. Sean Ryan Myers. Rebecca Marie Navalini. Laura Drew Netsley. Nathaniel Jackson Newton. Matthias Adam Omen Komen. Jillian Carly Oxendine. Annalie Myers Page, Associate's degree. Owen Michael Painter. Sarah Elizabeth Painter. Clayton Peck. SFA Andrew Pella. Jessica Stephanie Perez Gomez. Jack Allen Perry II. David A. Peters. Jordan Yvette Peterson Chandler. Isabella Rose Patridis. Alexi Alicia Plata. Christina Cristal Plata. Katie Alyssa Plath. Ashley Poling. Mario Logan Pollard. Gabriella Nevea Porter. Deshaun Presley. Reagan Michelle Pritt. Gabrielle Nicole Proctor. Ariana Lee Quinones. David Alexander Racy. Paige Nicole Rankins, Associate's degree. Leah Janae Reeves. Mahida Rahman. Woo! Courtney Lynn Renan, Associate's degree. Angeli Amy Reyes. Perla Janet Reyes. Lenora Deshaun Robinson. Tyree Raymond Robinson. Michelle Rojo Chavez, Associate's degree. Pedro Xavier Roman Rivera. Cecilia Ellen Taylor Rose. John Alger Rose III. John Robert Rulipaw. Lila Saar. Alex David Sanchez. Johan Estuardo Santos Mendez. Abigail Noel Shadley. Oliver Rose Schmidt. David Vernon Ray Scott. Desiree Paige Scott. Faith Lynn Seaton. D'Artagnan Lee Sherbin. Abigail Nicole Schrader, Associate's degree. Eric Alonso Sigüenza. William Tyler Sims. Marcus Donlente Slaughter. Caleb Tyler Smith. Nicholas Gage Smith. Rebecca Anderson Smith, Associate's degree. Griffin Osric Smithers. Kathleen H. Soria. Avery Huey Stanley. Angela Noel Steele. Elizabeth Imong Street, Associate's degree. Jasmine Lee Strother. Manny Jean-Paul Suarez. James Ethan Suter. Emily Nicole Sutphin. Autumn Mackenzie Taylor, Associate's degree. Daniel Benjamin Taylor. Henry Lawson Taylor. Terrence Anthony Thomas. Leo Giovanni Torres Alonso. Derek Jefferson Trejo Hernandez. Brianna J. Trice. Carla Michelle Trujillo Parra. Jackson Garrett Tall. Brianna Carol Ann Tyson. Elizabeth Ann Upton. Natalie Daniela Urahe. Selena Ventura. Taylor Lee Walker. Vanessa Nicole Walkup. Avery Elizabeth Ward, Associate's degree. Elijah Andre Malachi Waters. Jacob Andrew Weaver. Carrie Ann Weldon. Lewis James West. Katie Elizabeth Whalen. Lennon Lee Keith Whitaker. Desmond James Williams. Cuddy Wadia Rosetta Williams. Cameron Terrell Williams. Shaylin Ayana Williams. Aaron Marquise Wise. Rodney James Wise. Faith Elizabeth Wood. Sarah Elizabeth Woods. Jalen Michael Woodward. Cheyenne Marie Woodward. Gavin Michael Young. Evan Michael Woodworth. Parker Cannon Yates.
Would the Eastern View High School graduating class of 2021 please stand? By the authority vested in me by the Commonwealth of Virginia and by the Culpeper County School Board, I now declare that the class of 2021 are graduates of Eastern View High School with all rights, privileges, honors, and responsibilities thus granted. Graduates, you may now turn your tassels from right to left. Congratulations to the class of 2021. Parents and guests, we ask that you remain seated until the graduates have recessed out of the stadium.